Hello students, today we are going to learn about the topic projection. Now let's see what the projection is. It is a process of converting a 3D object into a 2D object. So here we have to convert a 3-dimensional object into a 2-dimensional object. Means we have to convert it into an image which can be displayed on a screen. It is also defined as mapping or a transformation of object in a projection plane or a view plane. The view plane is a displayed surface, means on which we are taking the projection of 3D object. Now view plane, it is a plane on which we are taking the projection. So projection is classified into two different types, parallel projection and perspective projection. Let's see it in detail one by one. First is the parallel projection. In this projection, the Z coordinate is eliminated and the parallel line from each vertex on the object are extended until they intersect the view plane. So as we know, we have to convert here the object into an image. So this is the view plane on which we have to take the projection of the object. So what we will do here, we eliminate the Z coordinate because we have to convert it into a 2D object. So Z coordinate will get removed. So here from each vertex, we have to extend the lines till it intersects the view plane from each corner of the object. And then we will join this particular lines. So we will get this particular face of the object as it is on a view plane. So this point of projections are the projection of vertices. Then projection of these vertices are joined together with a line segments. In this we can get the accurate view of all the sides of the object, but it does not give you the realistic representation of 3D object because we are getting only one face of the object at a time on the view plane. Now, this parallel projection is further classified as orthographic projection and oblique projection. Let's see it one by one. First is the orthographic projection. If the direction of projection is perpendicular to the view plane, then it is an orthographic projection. As we have seen in this figure, there is a view plane on which we have to take the projection. Then the projection of line will be perpendicular or at an angle of 90° to the view plane. It is the simplest parallel projection technique used in engineering drawing. So this technique we can use in the engineering drawing. In this, it is assumed that the observer is at infinite distance and the projection lines are parallel to each other and perpendicular to the plane of projection. For example, board and student. Then the board are, board and student means whenever there is a classroom, the students are right in front of the board, sitting in front of the board. So that is nothing but the example of orthographic projection. So in orthographic projection, we can get the front, side, back, top and bottom view of the object. As we have seen in this figure, this is the original figure. So here we can obtain the top view of the object, front view of the object, side view of the object and so on. So accurate view of the object we can get into the orthographic projection. Now this orthographic projection is further classified as multi-view projection and axonometric projection. Axonometric projection is further classified as isometric, diametric and trimetric projection. Now let's see it one by one. First is the multi-view projection, in which we can get the different views of the same object so that we can represent a 3D object on a 2D plane. So here we have considered as an example this object and we have got the different views, that is the top view, front view and side view of the object. Next is the axonometric projection. Now axonometric means to measure along the axis. Axonometric projection that shows more than one side of the object. Okay, now in this we can see once more than one side of an object at a time. It shows an image object is viewed from a skew direction in order to reveal more than one side. at a time we can see two sides of the object. Okay, for that we have to further classify it into three different types, and we will see it one by one. First is the isometric. Now in this projection, angle between the three axes are equal, like a equilateral triangle. So three sides are equal means the AB is equals to AC is equals to AD. All the three angles will be equal into the isometric projection. So if we project a cube into a 2D surface, we will get all the three sides are equal. In the diametric projection, the two angles between the axes are equal, means AB is equals to AC, and the AD will have different length in a diametric. Two axes will have the different same length and one axis will have the different length. In the trimetric projection, it can be drawn using three axes having different angles between them. Now here, all the three sides will have the different angles. AB is not equal to AD is not equal to AC in this way. So in this way, all these methods are used for the furniture design. If we want to produce the furniture, we can use this design. Axonometric projection is good for the rectangular structure rather than the curved object. So that's why it is used for the creation of furnitures. Now, the next type of parallel projection is the oblique projection. Now, if the projection direction is not perpendicular to the projection plane, then it is a oblique projection, but are parallel from the object to the projection plane. Now, this is the view plane on which we have to take the projection of the 3D object. So, projection line is not perpendicular here. Okay, but it makes an angle other than 90 degree. Some different angle it will make. Now, let's see how it works. It is further classified as cavalier projection and cabinet projection. First, see what is a cavalier projection. It occurs when the projection vectors forms an angle of 45 degree with the z-axis. Now, when we want to take the projection on the view plane, it makes an angle of exactly or approximately 45 degree. So that's why what happened, we will get the z-axis value as it is, and x and y value will get reduced as shown in the second diagram. Means the object looks like an elongated object in the cavalier projection. Second is the cabinet projection. In this, it makes an angle of approximately 30 degree or the angle of 26.6 degree along with the z-axis. This cabinet projection is more realistic than cavalier because the reduced length of edges that are perpendicular to the view plane. So in this way, the proper object is this. After making an angle of 30 degree, the projected object on the view plane will be like this. Now, the next type of projection is the perspective projection. Now, in perspective projection, the lines of projection are not parallel, but they converge at a single point called as a vanishing point or a center of projection. In this, the realistic views are produced, but relative proportions are not preserved. Okay, so here the projection lines are converge at a single point other than the origin. We will call it as a center of projection or a vanishing point. So here we will draw this line segment and we will get the exact view of the particular image or object onto the view plane. Okay, so the accurate view we will get, but the dimensions will be different. This perspective projection can be of three different types: 1 point, 2 point, and 3 point perspective projection. Now, to draw the image of an object on a 2D plane, that is a XY plane, the center of projection should be beyond the XY plane. So here, what we have to find out? We have to find out the coordinates of the object which we are displaying onto the view plane. So the center of projection is here. This is our view plane and this is our original object. Now, the dimensions will get different, it will get changed when we take the projection onto the view plane. So we have to find out this new coordinate of the object. We will call it as xp, yp. So to find out this xp and yp, what we have to do? First, we have to find it one by one. So to draw the image on xy plane, we have to find out xp, yp, that is the projection of points on the screen. Now let's find it out. So to find the yp, we have to write the equation y upon z plus d is equal to yp upon d. From this equation, we will get the value of yp. Now to find the xp, how we can write it? X upon z plus d is equals to xp upon d. In this way, we will find out the value of xp like this. Okay. Thus, we will get the coordinates of the projected points on the screen or on the view plane. So, we will get the value of xp and yp. So, these are the coordinates of the image which we are projected onto the view plane. And the z coordinate will be 0 because it is a two-dimensional image which is displayed on a view plane. Now, let's see one-point perspective projection. In one-point perspective projection, we have only one vanishing point or a center of projection. Okay, so these are some of the examples of the one-point perspective projection. The railway track, here only one point vanishing point is there. Here also we have seen only one vanishing point. Here also we are having only one vanishing point. So this is a one-point perspective projection. Now in two-point perspective projection, we can see there are two different vanishing points. One is this vanishing point and one is this vanishing point. Okay, so we can view the object from two different sides. Okay, so this is a two-point perspective projection. Three-point perspective projection means we have three vanishing points, 1, 2, and 3. Means we can see this side also, and top view also. So in this way, we can view the different sides of the object in a three-point perspective projection. This is all about the projections, that is a parallel projection and perspective projection and its different types. Thank you.